Today I'm working on the F-150's electrical system upgrade so I could try to hook up this bass amp. It's a lovely day outside, the weather is perfect, and all I need to do is upgrade a couple grounds and upgrade my charging cable. Just kidding, my battery post just broke off. I'm fucked! Now I can't just simply enjoy my day and upgrade my grounds because I have to drive out to the valley and swap my battery in the parking lot because there's a core charge, so I need to swap the battery there. In the San Fernando Valley, I'm gonna get stabbed in the back by an El Salvadorian gang member. I have to risk my life for a fucking battery. Amplifier is produced by Soundman Enterprises Inc., Mobile Solutions, CT Sounds, and Extreme Autosports. Rafa's family lives out there. I can't go there after what I said about his mother. They're gonna kill me and steal my Macintosh amp.
Shut the fuck up, Doug. Jesus Christ.
Excellent!
This battery is super old, too. That's alright, I should be able to drive out to the valley without a problem. I'll just use the side post on this Optima battery. Hook my ground up temporarily. Just kidding, the goddamn side post terminal doesn't fit. Fucked again! Oh my god. Let's see if this bitch starts right now. This battery needs to be replaced anyway. When I first got this truck new in 2010, I took the yellow top out of my Toyota Tacoma, which I traded in, and put it in the F-150 on the day I got it. That was 7 years ago. Shit. You guys keep saying Optima batteries suck. This has been in here for 7 years. You're acting like you're some kind of battery expert. If it lasts 7 years, it doesn't suck. There's reasons I like to use these things. This yellow top Optima lasted 7 years. I'm using another Optima, okay? Get that through your fat head. Stinger wire is oxygen-free tinned copper. I like to solder on my copper lugs, so I need tinned copper. And I can't have my copper corrode inside the shield if any air gets in the wire shield. This is scientific shit. I may have replaced this once under warranty because these Optimas have a 3-year warranty, but I don't think I did. I think this is the same 7-year-old battery that I originally put in here. Wow, this thing is old and reliable, like Rafa's mother. And half full of battery acid because the bitch does so much meth. She's full, half full of battery, like a dead battery.
Jesus Christ.
My God. And the post is broken like her tooth. bit louder. Teeth, you have two teeth. What is wrong?
Seriously, don't fuck around right now. Fuck off.
I'm telling you guys, yellow top Optimas are great. It's good. In fact, I have a good deal on the used one I could get you. It has a slightly cracked post, but it's still. It'll hold up to 15.5 volts. If you want this old battery, let me know. I'll have to sell it to you for full price because there's a core exchange. So if I don't core exchange this and get the discount on the new battery, I might have to charge you extra. Because I gotta make a profit. I'm swapping this battery in the parking lot because there's a core exchange. I'm gonna get stabbed out here. I'm a white boy with my car unlocked, stereo shit everywhere, swapping my battery in the parking lot in the San Fernando Valley. I'm a sitting duck. They're gonna kill me. I should have brought Rafa with me. I decided to grab a blue top Optima because it has two extra threaded top posts instead of the GM side post like a yellow top. But other than that, it's the same style battery. Swapped it out, hooked it up, it's ready to go. This was 220 out the door with the core exchange. Now I'm ready to get this thing back to the shop and upgrade my wiring, which I was trying to do in the first place. Before Rafa broke my battery post. It had to be him.
It's not the time for this.
It wasn't me. I didn't even touch anything on it.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
So this is 750 cold cranking amps, just like the last one. Deep cycle. Blue top has these separate posts on the top instead of the GM side posts. Since my side post terminals won't fit the battery box, I figured get the same size battery, slap it in. We'll add a second one later. I almost bought a bigger one. It's just a little bit too tall. I don't want the hood to hit the battery. Now I can upgrade the ground from the battery to the body. Then I need to upgrade the charging wire from the alternator to the battery. Then I need to upgrade the grounding strap from the motor to the body and from the body to the chassis, which is two grounding straps. This is called the Big Six. The Big Three doesn't work on trucks because if you upgrade the grounding strap from the body to the motor, you have to upgrade the grounding strap from the body to the chassis. Or the motor to the chassis. because you only upgraded your ground from the battery to the body. Unless you did a ground from the battery to the chassis, and from the chassis to the... If you pull a lot of current through a small ground, the ground wire is going to heat up. And I have my power wires running over my gas tank. It's going to heat up, melt a hole in the gas tank, ignite the fuel. I'm also rerouting this power wire because it is running over the gas tank and I don't want a power wire over a gas tank. We're just gonna say it's not a good idea. I wanna pop it in the vehicle sooner so I could add another set of fuse holders in the cubby, and that'll make for a much safer system. Now all I have to worry about is the zip ties falling off and the power wire tangling up in the drive shaft, which might not be bad. So far we have our zero gauge power wire running to our base amp circuit breaker. 4 gauge and 8 gauge go to this post, along with the factory wiring to go to the factory fuse box. This is really making like Rafa's mom's butt cheeks and coming together, which doesn't happen very often. I'm still waiting on a couple small parts. I need some grommets, but this base amp is pretty much ready to hook up. We have our zero gauge ground on this post, factory grounds, and those both go to this factory ground right here. Now we just need to upgrade the charging cable to a zero, which will go to this center post, which is open. We ended up with this third post open. These are all just stacked on the first post. I've just been cutting my zero gauge off of my extra wire. I ran that whole 50-foot roll. Next, I'll make some grounds for the base amp. And then I'm gonna pop this power wire in the truck sooner, because right now it goes over the gas tank. I'd rather it come in the truck and maybe through this cubby, so I could put a second fuse holder just for safety. Just so there's a fuse holder on both ends, in case the power wire ever shorts in the back. I didn't finish everything I wanted to get done. I still have a couple other wires to upgrade because I had to run and go grab that battery. But replacing the battery definitely helped out because of the extra top posts. And now we have a fresh new battery that's all the way full of fresh battery acid. Unlike my old battery, which was half full of battery acid, like Rafa's mom, because she does so much meth. Are you coming with me? She's made up of half battery acid.
Whatever, you shut the fuck up.
And this fresh new battery is like Rafa's dad. all the way full of battery acid. Because he hogs all the mess.
Are you done so you can shut the fuck up, you fucking sorry ass bitch?
He always hides it from the bitch.
Got him! Got him!
Now instead of this going along that cross member and going over the tank, we just have it strapped to the cross member running up here. I drilled a hole through here and here, which is inside of the cubby. We have a zip tie here.
I also wanted to talk about the features of this new Sony head unit, but we'll do that next week. Also, the mule transmission is done getting rebuilt, so we got to pick that up. So that'll also be next week. Now we have too much to do. I don't have time to do all this. I gotta get the box in and the trannies back. And when I say the trannies back, I'm talking about Rafa's mom just got here. What are you doing here, bitch?
Are you done so you can shut the fuck up, you fucking sorry ass?
Can I help you? Ah! Here's a quick update on your orders. These are all cleaned up, ready to sign. This is the new batch that needs to get cleaned up and quality control checked. And the knuckles are shipping out. This stack is sanded. These are what they look like fresh off the plasma cutter. Thank you guys so much for your support. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think about today's episode. Come back next week for fresh new episodes of Amplified. You guys have a great weekend. Support Amplified by buying iPad dash kits and Soundman merch at soundmanca.com. Become a car audio master with the tools and trainings available for mobile solutions at mobilesolutions-usa.com. Receive a discount on all the best car audio equipment from CT Sounds by using coupon code SOUNDMAN at ctsounds.com. And come down to see me and Rafa at Extreme Autosports in Santa Clarita and get great deals on audio and performance equipment and installation.